Hello friends and welcome back on my channel. My name is Alex and for today video I have this assembly exercise for you. This is very easy. This assembly have two parts. This one, the base, and this one. So let's start. For this we'll be following this sketch. First we'll start with the base and then we'll make the second part. First we'll have to open a new part. And here we'll open a sketch in the top plane. Here we'll make a rectangle, center rectangle. And with smart dimension, we'll dimension this rectangle. Here will be 80 millimeters. And here will be 40. Now we'll make two center lines. One vertical and one horizontal. And now we'll make one circle here, and with smart dimension we'll dimension this circle. We'll have the diameter 4 millimeters, and from this center point to this line will be 5 millimeters, and from this center point to this other line will be also 5. Now with mirror entities we'll select this circle, and that mirror about we'll select this center line. Press OK. And now we'll use mirror again and we'll select these two circles, and that mirror about this center line. Press OK. Now go to features and we'll use extruded boss base. Here the thickness will be 5 millimeters. Press OK. And now let's make this plane white to see it better. Now we'll open a sketch on this face. So select this face and sketch. Normal 2. And here we'll make the next sketch. First we'll make 3 lines. 2 vertical and 1 horizontal. Now make these 2 points horizontal. Select this point from the middle of this line and this point, and select here make vertical. And now with smart dimension we'll have to dimension these 3 lines, here will be 20 millimeters. And now we'll select tangent arc and we'll make here a tangent arc just like this. And now it's smart dimension, we'll give here a dimension from this point to this center point. Here will be 25 millimeters. And now we'll select circle command and we'll make here a circle. This circle will have the diameter 8 millimeters. Perfect. Now we'll have to extrude this sketch. So we'll go to features and we'll use extruded boss base, and here we'll select reverse direction, and the thickness will be 10 millimeters. Press OK. And now we'll have to mirror this on this side. So for this we'll go to mirror, and from this arrow here we'll select right plane, and that feature to mirror we'll select boss extruded tool and press OK. Nice. Now select this face and open a sketch, normal 2. And here we'll make a corner rectangle. So from here select corner rectangle. And we'll start this corner rectangle from this edge. And we'll make it just like this. Now we'll select this point from the middle of this line and this center point. And we'll select here make vertical. Now it's smart dimension. We'll dimension this rectangle, so here will be 15, and from this edge to this line here will be 57.50. Nice. Now go to features and use extruded boss base. We'll have to select here reverse direction, and the thickness will be also 10 millimeters. Press OK. And now I have to open a sketch on this face, normal too. And here we'll have to make a circle. Just like this, and then select this circle, this edge, select here make tangent. And then select this circle and this edge, select here make tangent. And here do the same. And now select line, and we'll make a line starting from this point. Just like this, and then we'll end here. Make sure that this line is tangent to this circle. On this side the same. And now we'll have to use trim entities command to cut this part of the circle. Press here OK. And now we'll go to features and we'll use extruded cut. And here at blind we'll select up to surface and we'll select this face. Press OK. And now we'll have to use mirror for this body like we did for this one. So let's open mirror, and here at mirror face plane we'll have to select front plane. And at features to mirror, select boss extruded 3 and cut extruded 1. Press OK. Now this is almost done. We have to use fillet for these edges. So select fillet command. If the radius will be 5 millimeters, and we'll have to select these 4 edges. And press OK. Now this is done. Let's save it. I'll save it on my desktop. Face. Okay, and we'll have to open a new part. So open a new part. And here we'll have to open a sketch in the front plane, where we'll make the... Just a second. We'll have to make this part. So first we'll make the path for this, and then we'll use swept boss base. So first we'll make with line this path. So select line and we'll start from here. Just like this. Now it's smart dimension, we have to dimension this. Here will be 30 millimeters. This line will have 68.25. Here will be 40. And the last one, 142. Now we have to use sketch fillet, and here the radius will be 5 millimeters. For these three corners. Press OK. And now we'll go to features and we'll use swept boss base. Here we'll select circular profile and the diameter will be 7.5 millimeters. And now we'll have to select the path, which is this sketch. And press OK. Make it plain white. And now this part is also done. We'll have to save it too. Okay, and now we'll have to assemble them. So I will go back to this, to the part 1. And from this arrow, from file, we'll select make assembly from part. Now we'll have to click to place it. Let's make this plain white. And now we'll have to import the other part. So go to insert components, and from there I will select part 2. And now select this face with this face and select here concentric. Okay. Now we'll select this face with this face. We'll have to limit the movement of this part in this base. So go here, mate, and we'll select from advanced mates. We'll select here distance. The minimum distance will be 8 mm, and the maximum distance will be 58 mm. Press here OK. And now this is limited. Now what we'll have to do is to limit the movement of this part like this. We don't want it to rotate, to be rotated in the base. So for this we'll select, we'll go here to this arrow from part 2 and we'll select front plane, and then with control pressed we'll select this face from the base and then go up here to mate, and here we'll select from advanced mates, we'll select angle. Here the minimum angle will be 0 degrees and the maximum angle will be 180 degrees. Let's see if this is good. So this is not good. We have to reverse the direction of this last mate. So in order to do this, go here to this arrow from mates, click on this limit angle and go here to edit feature, and from here we'll select reverse alignment and press OK. And now this should be OK. Now it's good. It's only rotating up. Nice, disassembly is done. Thank you for watching and I hope to see you in the next video. If you like what I'm doing, you can subscribe to see more. You can help me with a like, comment with your opinion. Thank you and I hope to see you in the next video. Yeah.